I would like to get to know you. So I get out personal portraits. I can hear you asking, what kind of game is this? Well, games are processes that are designed to bring about a set of potential results. Oftentimes that result is a sort of tension, competition or emotional ratcheting up tension that people like to engage in. It clarifies the moment, that strong feeling. Personal portraits is a set of rules, a process that is designed for a different sort of set of emotional results that also clarifies the moment. And that is a sort of closeness, I believe, and a sort of a clarity of self. It's a very selfish game. So it's cooperative. Why didn't you just say it's cooperative? I mean, I've played cooperative games before. Well, the reason I didn't say it was cooperative is because it's not really cooperative. I mean, we're going to cooperate with each other in a way, but there's no real problem. There's no real, we're not trying to win the game. We're not facing the game. We're not competing with the game. There's no competition in this game at all. Well, then, how is it a game? Well, remember, games are can be seen as a set of processes, a set of rules, a process. I don't know why I said set of processes. It's a set of rules that's designed to kind of give us a space to process in order to get some to kind of clarify the moment and make it a meaningful moment in some way, or maybe elicit some emotion or have some desired result. And in this case, the desired result is just different. It's not the competition in other games is really just a means to get a desired result. It's not the purpose of the process. I can see this as maybe starting to become very stressful for you. So I think maybe if we just started, we just started playing the game together, you would start to understand through play personal portraits. First of all, each of us are going to get one of these charts. These charts are our play mat. These are indicative of us. This is our game reflection of ourself. Because really, personal portraits is a game about getting to know those around you and also yourself. It's sort of a psychology kind of game. We're each going to be dealt 10 of these cards. We're going to put them in a stack. We're not going to look at them yet. Then we're going to each be dealt out one of these Cohen cards, which we're going to put on our mat. We can choose either side to place face up. And that's going to be a question that we use to focus our explorations into each other's identities and our own identities. So each of us is going to have our question that people are going to use when interacting with our play mat, and we're going to use when interacting with each other's play mats. And we're going to be answering these questions later on in the game. Then, with fullest intention, we're going to reach into this bag that my wife sewed for me. If you don't have a bag, you can, you know, place these on the table. But since you're playing with me, I have a bag. You can reach in the bag, and with purest of intentions, draw one of these cards out. These are our Gypsy Says cards, and you're going to put it face down, so you're not going to look at this. This is going to be kind of like the treat that you get after we finish this process together. Now let's get to the bulk of play here. So I'll go first just to show you how it's done. I'm going to take the top one on my stack here, and that's investments. So you have numbered 1 to 10 on your board, and I have to decide how important investments are to you. I think investments are very important, but I want to make room for something more important than investments. So I'm going to put it at number 2. I think you're an investor sort. Otherwise, you would not be watching this, because you're trying to invest in your own future of gaming. You have God for me. Looking at me, I think you think that I'm pretty into God. But again, you want to leave room for more important things. So you put God at number 3 for me. UFOs. I think you're kind of ambivalent about UFOs. So I'm going to put it at... but kind of towards the positive side. So I'm going to put it at number 5 for you. Termite control you have for me. Now, looking around, we're at my house, so you have some clues here. Looking around, you see I have a lot of wood. a lot of bare wood in my room. And so you would think termite control would be very important for me, because if the termites ate this room, it would fall down on my game collection. And you know I like games. So I think you're going to put termite control slightly less than God. And bachelor. Oh, what? Sorry, I'm forgetting who I... Okay, compromise is what I have for you. I don't think you like to compromise very much, I think. But it's important that other people compromise with you when your position is less tractable. So I'm going to put compromise number 7 for you. Put bachelor for me. Now, you happen to know that I'm married, so you're going to put bachelor at number 10, I think. I have kilts for you. How important are kilts for you? I think kilts are pretty important. More important than UFOs, less than investments. It's nice to have these posts here to kind of decide from. So I'll put kilts. I'll put them right above UFOs, I think. Sleep. Now, it's currently 4 in the morning here, so you're thinking that sleep is not that important to me. You would be wrong. Well, I can't talk about that right now. So you're going to put sleep down at number 9. Personal appearance. I think your appearance is very important to you. Should make it go above kilts, because kilts are part of your personal appearance. Is it above investments? I'm going to say, yeah. Oh, that's hard. I really got to follow my heart here. I'm going to say yes. I'm going to go ahead and do that. Nostalgia. And nostalgia for me. You think that nostalgia is important to me. But not, yeah. Oh, we'll put nostalgia there. Silk. Okay, silk is perfect. I'm glad I didn't put personal appearance here, because I can put silk right here in between kilts and investments for you. We kind of have a nice flow. I've been forgetting about your Cohen, and that's a common mistake with this game, to forget about the Cohen when making these decisions. Especially when you're having a tough time making a decision, it's good to go to the Cohen to kind of help you come up with the answer. Cats. Well, you've seen Mushmow, so you'll put cats at number 2, just above God for me. Job. See, now here's one of the tricky things with personal portraits. I kind of wish I had space up here for job. But since you're so good with investments, you don't really need to work. So we'll put job. But you think it's important that people have jobs. So we'll put job at number 8 for you. Fruit. I think you're going to put fruit. You would like to put fruit higher for me, but you don't want to put it at number 1. So you're going to put it at number 6. I have kindness for you. Am I doing this right, or am I getting it mixed up? I think I might have mixed one of them up. I'll do an extra one for you. Let's see. I've got 3 spaces left. I think I did one of them in the wrong order, so I'm going to do an extra one for you. Emotions. Emotions are not super important to you right now, but they are going to be after you play this game. So I'll put it at number 9 instead of number 10. At least I'm going to take a double turn. No, you'll take a turn now. Sorry, I messed it up, didn't I? Excess. I think you think that excess is really important to me. Okay. Did I deal out one too many? This is not often a problem. I dealt out one too many. That's what happened. Kindness. I think kindness is not your top priority. Teachers. I think you think that I like teachers. But again, once we fill it up, we kind of have to go downward. And habits. I have to put habits here. You have to put toys here. Okay, so that was very good. Now, you can take a moment, and I'll take a moment to do a reality check. And what you're going to do with the reality check is you're going to take a look at your thing, and you can do this at home. Okay, so this is the way I see you, with some constraints of the process, right? Because I couldn't just look at them all and put them from 1 to 10. I had to do them one at a time and reveal them one at a time. So that gives you a little bit of a safety valve too, right? You don't have to be spot on when you're doing someone else's, and you don't have to feel that self-conscious about it, because there is this constraint, and everyone understands that there's this constraint that you have to do one at a time. So it makes it a little little better. You don't have to feel embarrassed about getting someone's personal portrait wrong. So you're going to take this and put this in the order that you feel works best for you, 1 to 10. You can do that right now. And in the meantime, I'm going to do mine right here. So I will be putting mine in the order that I see myself at this moment, because I think selves change moment to moment, even within a person. And then we'll check back with each other and kind of do our reality check together. And sorry, fads didn't get used. That was an extra card. So we'll put that away. While you're doing your portrait, I think I'll just talk to you a little bit about the game. You can tune me out. This part's not very important. And just my past experiences with the game, because this is a review video, as well as a getting to know you activity. So this game is a lot of fun. People like to look at themselves. They like to think about themselves. They like to think about others. This gives a process for people to kind of cut through the chit-chat and get to kind of really getting to know the other person in a way that seems very pleasurable to people. I've dropped this in a lot of different social situations. I've had people of all ages try this game, and in game events, and it's always the table where there's the most laughter, is the table where they're playing personal portraits. And it does bring about a sort of closeness, and it's general an enjoyable process for people. It's been my experience. Probably the best sort of kind of truest expression of the party game, or one aspect of the party game, and that is to facilitate socialization. This is one of the better examples of that I've tried. So I'm done talking about the game now. If you haven't fully finished your reality check on your board, go ahead and pause the video now, or you can keep finishing up as I show you mine. But you know, take your time. There's no rush. We have as long as you have to do this. All right, so now I'm going to go through my portrait, and I've done my reality check. I'm going to talk about why I made the changes I made. So first I put nostalgia at number 10. I don't find nostalgia to be very useful. I think it's very easy to, especially as, you know, the older you get, even young kids have this problem, to just kind of get bogged down in things that have happened. And I think once you start doing that, you kind of stop living. If I had experience with termites, I think termite control would be more important to me. But since I haven't had termite problems, I don't think about it a lot. And so, I think termites are the bugs that are kind of cow-like, that have an ongoing war with the ants, and I think that's pretty interesting, but that I don't really, I haven't picked a side. I kind of, my heart's more with the termites, I think, than the ants. Being a bachelor, if I did have some nostalgia, I might have some for being a bachelor. There's something about it, but I prefer my life now, I think. God is interesting to think about. I like people's conceptions of God, and thinking about that. Teachers are great. Sure. It's good to teach people. Cats are also, I in general get along well with cats, but, I love the cats that I've lived with. Most of them. Fruit is wonderful to eat. It's, I think one of the better types of foods is fruit. Sleep is really important to me. I don't get enough of it. But it oftentimes defines my day, how much sleep I got when I'm sleeping. I think being asleep is also enjoyable, but I don't sleep enough. Excess. I can be excessive. You can see here. And yeah, it's important. Sometimes I think about, I might actually, while I'm talking about it, I might actually put sleep above excess, because I didn't have a lot to say about excess. And toys, I really like toys a lot. Okay, so you can, if you want to message me how you changed your own, or make a video of your own, or talking about it. However, I would love to hear you talk about your own, how you've done your own reality check. So we'll just give you one last glimpse. I'll go slow over the ones, and I'll read them out loud. And then you can put them in any order you want. There's no rules for how you put them in order. You just go from 1 to 10. Personal appearance, investments, silk, kilts, UFOs, habits, compromise, job, emotions, kindness. So now I have to answer my question, and you need to answer yours. So here's yours again, so you can think about it while I'm answering mine. What music most uplifts you? Can you name specific musicians or songs that have especially touched you? All right, so you think about that, and you can also message me your answer. And I will answer mine. Mine is a little bit dated in a way. I mean, there's still magazines around. If you could be the editor of any single magazine, what publication would you pick? Now, my mind first started going towards like things like National Geographic or maybe Nintendo Power or some sort of very specific magazine specific to my interests. That would be fun to edit. But I think I would actually enjoy editing more something like maybe People or Us Weekly. So it would just kind of be fun to try to change those magazines into something different. And I think being editor, one would be able to do that if one could deal with the pressures of the magazine's current momentum and try to change that. All right, so let's move on to the next part, which is where each of us gets to read our own sort of special fortune, which is kind of after we've gone through this experience of laughter and connection and self-reflection, this is kind of something that you take after the game into your life afterwards. And we can share this or not. So I'm going to read mine quietly to myself. You can read yours quietly to yourself. And if you choose you want to share it with me, you can. Otherwise, don't. Interesting. Okay, I hope that gave you time to read it. If not, you can always rewind or have paused it. I don't really feel comfortable sharing mine with you at this time, and I think that's okay. I think I've gotten to know you better, but I don't feel like I know you well enough to get to know to share that with you. So that was Personal Portraits.